U.S. shipmaker Huntington Ingalls Industries has launched the latest Virginia-class nuclear-powered attack submarine, the USS Delaware, SSN 791. It was put to water for the first time at the company's Newport News shipyard on December 17th. USS Delaware is the 18th Virginia-class SSN and the 9th to be delivered by Newport News shipyard. Construction on Delaware started in September 2013. The boat is the final Virginia-class Block 3 submarine to be launched. The U.S. Navy's Block 3 fleet will consist of 8 submarines. The U.S. Navy has already awarded a $17.6 billion contract for 10 Block 4 Virginia-class boats in 2014. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the capabilities of USS Delaware. Let's get started. The Virginia-class, sometimes referred to as SSN 774-class, is a class of nuclear-powered fast attack submarines in service with the United States Navy. Virginia-class is designed to replace older Los Angeles-class submarines, many of which have already been decommissioned. Virginia-class submarines will be acquired through 2043 and are expected to remain in service till 2070. Virginia-class submarines are designed for a broad spectrum of open ocean and littoral missions. Their primary purpose is to take out enemy surface combatants and submarines, and the secondary task is to execute land attack missions. USS Delaware has a length of 115 meters. To give viewers a perspective, its length is slightly greater than that of a football field. It displaces around 7,900 tons. USS Delaware, like all Block 3 variant, is acknowledged to be able to move to depths of 240 meters, or 800 feet, but allegedly capable of going down to 490 meters, that's 1,600 feet. A single S9G reactor that produces around 30 megawatts powers USS Delaware. The reactor features improved corrosion resistance and reduced life cycle cost. It also has reduced size and weight, enabling the submarine to pack more weapons and sensors. The S9G reactor is designed to operate for 33 years without refueling. So USS Delaware has a practically unlimited range, limited by only food supplies and maintenance requirements. The reactor produces enough power to propel USS Delaware over 25 knots, that's 46 kilometers per hour or 29 miles per hour. Though the actual numbers are classified and may be significantly higher. The Virginia-class is the first to use photonic sensors instead of traditional periscope. The class is equipped with high-resolution cameras, along with light intensification and infrared sensors, as well as an infrared laser rangefinder. Block 3 variant of Virginia-class has redesigned elements and features several types of sonar arrays. 1. It incorporates a large aperture bow, LAB, water-backed array, which replaces the traditional air-backed spherical array. This is the main sonar and one of the most powerful sonar mounted in any of the submarines in the world. 2. High-frequency active sonars mounted in the sail and bow. These supplement the main sonar array, improving anti-submarine warfare performance. 3. A fiber optic sonar array consisting of 3 flat panels are present in either side of the hull. 4. For coverage above and behind the submarine, a high-frequency sonar is mounted on both sides of the submarine's sail. USS Delaware is also equipped with a low-frequency towed sonar array and a high-frequency towed sonar array. USS Delaware is deadly as it's packed with different kinds of weapons to knock out varied targets. 1. 2 large diameter Virginia payload tubes, each capable of launching 6 Tomahawk cruise missiles for a total of 12 missiles. Tomahawk is a long-range, all-weather cruise missile that's used for land-based attacks. It has a long range of 1,200 to 2,500 kilometers, enabling them to be launched from far off. Two, four 533-millimeter torpedo tubes for the Mark 48 torpedo. There's a capacity to carry up to 24 Mark 48 torpedoes in the weapons chamber. These torpedoes have a range in excess of 50 kilometers or 31 miles and can be used to take out enemy submarines and surface vessels. 3. Like all Virginia-class, Delaware can also lay different types of mines, including the Mark 60 Captor encapsulated torpedo mines. 4. An integral lockout lock-in chamber is incorporated into the hull for special operations. The chamber can host a mini submarine, such as Northrop Grumman's Advanced SEALS delivery system, that can be used to transport special warfare forces, such as Navy SEAL teams.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.